The citation is being wound up by the positive contact among by mobile teammates. So this work has been done in collaboration with the people. So Kiso and Kuita, our laboratory members, our laboratory outright, against heart, due to Seattle. So this is our driving, I told. First, I make a brief introduction of the ground state of microbial neurons and the public. And then I introduce the crystal structure and the low temperature magnitude static properties of varying global chemotherapy. And thirdly, I make a brief introduction of a cellular experiment of the citation in spin one of global neurons and the public. And I present the result of our neutral scattering experiment on the bipolar antimony and discuss the result. So this is a reference related to my talk. So the steam of our bipolar antimony is a prototypical brass-related quantum family, which exhibits the remarkable quantum made one effect owing to the synergy effect of frustration and quantum fluctuations. The naive question is, what is the ground state? In 1973, Anderson proposed a resolution by its theory. So this state is composed of spin singlet. The spin changes the singlet pair from moment to moment. So the so translational symmetry is not broken. So the state is like making his fascinating theory activated theoretical studies in the ground state. At present, to the best of my knowledge, the theoretical consensus is that the ground state is an ordered state with 120 degrees fractions like this. However, due to the strong quantum fluctuation, the size of the moment is much reduced to full moment. Although the ground state is similar to the classical ground state, but the 2½ triangular magnet demonstrates the quantum phase transition magnetic field. In a classical spin model, the magnetization is monotonic up to the saturation. However, for quantum case, the up-down spin state is stabilized by the quantum order by the slowdown mechanism in a finite field range, so that the magnetization has plateaued at one third of saturation magnetization. So to verify the theory, we need the model substance. Therefore, we have been looking for substance, which is a realization of spin one half triangular antimagnet. So please let me introduce the structure and potential properties of bipolar antimonies. So this is the crystal structures. The blue octahedron is the cobalt 06 octahedron centered by cobalt 2 plus, which has effective spin of one half at low temperatures. So cobalt 2 plus forms a uniform triangular lattice in the AB plane. So these triangular radii are well separated by barium 2 plus and antimony 2 oxygen 9 downplane style. Therefore, we can expect a good two-dimensionality. The effective plutonium at the low temperature of this compound is described by spin one half FZ3 model. In this compound, the distortion of the octahedron is very small. Therefore, the transverse component and the longitudinal component are nearly equal. Therefore, the model crosses to Hidekazu. So, owing to the high symmetric crystal lattice, the anti-symmetric gelatin-spin-Morita interaction is absent. So due to weak interlinear couplings, three-dimensional orders in space and three quantum scale. So this is a magnetization process measured for powder sample on single crystals. For powder sample, the experimental result almost perfectly coincides with theory. Therefore, we can see the variable antimony best realization scheme of art by analysis of the However, for single crystal, we observe anisotropic magnetization time. So, when field parallel to the triangular layer, so we can observe magnetization magnetization plateau. However, for this field direction, we observe the cusp instead of plateau. So this isotropy is caused by weak, easily playing isotropy and weak, so non-diagonal interlinear shape interaction. However, this isotropy of magnetization process is successfully described by the theory. From these measurements, we see the barium cobalt antimony is close to the ideal scheme of carbon, triangular and sharp magnetization anomaly indicate the exchange disorder is weak. So, although the ground state nature is well understood. However, the magnetic excitation are less well understood. The magnetic excitation investigated significantly by various approaches. So this is the result of a series expansion. One of the authors, Professor Shin, is a chairman. The theoretical consensus is limited only to the single magnum excitation. The low energy excitation near a point is described by linear spin wave theory. However, at high energy dispersion is significantly denormalized downwards, so that the dispersion curve becomes flat. And the bottom right minimum is observed at the endpoint. So this minimum is interpreted as a spin-on, anti-spin-on quantum state. So the characteristics of low energy and high energy excitations are different. Experimentally, so the excitation of triangular lattice magnetization was observed using the barium cobalt antimony by Fan and others. So this is a experimental result, experimentally observed excitation spectrum. The lower panel is analysis using the convenience. So they observed flat dispersion and at a point minimum. However, so the energy range is limited below the 3 electron volt. And the excitation spectrum looks rather indistinct. So we also measured magnetization in elastic visual scattering on the barium cobalt antimony. The instrument we use is the Amadeus, the cold neutron disk chopper spectrometer installed at the material life science facility. The single crystal were wrong for the belt. So, in measurements, so we first set the incident, so we vector the incident into parallel to the star direction, and we obtained a triangle excitation. And then we measured the excitation detail by rotating samples. By rotating samples, we can access wider momentum space. this is the excitation data. So the upper two corners excitation from the, this direction, and the lower corner excitation of that direction. So these two directions are symmetric direction. So in order to obtain the intensity, we have some statistics. We integrate the scattering and the c direction. So assuming the two-dimensional knowledge. So from these experimental data, so we can see the excitation is has three-stage energy structures. The lower stage is composed of single quantum excitation, two branches of single quantum excitation. So these branches are well defined. So we can see bottom right minimum in low, not only lower branch, but also higher branch. The second and third energy stage is composed of intense and dispersive continuum, which extend to the high energy about 6 million to 19 million. So first we compare the result with the linear scheme which showed the white line is the calculation using this linear scheme which showed the parameter used these two, which are determined from the saturation optimization, saturation field and the zero field we have observed by electrodes in measurements. So the excitation near the pin point, the lower bound of the excitation is almost or inside this linear scheme series. This means the low energy excitation near pin point can be described by so linear scheme series. However, the further the wave vector moves away from the pin point, the more excitation energy deviate downwards. So the high energy or high energy excitation, the dispersion is significantly normalized downwards. These two observations are consistent with zero. So in order to check the two-dimensionality, we measure the dispersion from the C-star direction. This is the excitation spectrum of the 1/3, 1/3, and the 2/1 excitation spectrum of the 1/2, 1/2. So for these two directions, we can see the dispersion. So we dispose by the weak interlayer coupling. However, for these directions, the excitation spectra strike parallel to the horizontal axis. This means the excitation is dispersionless. So this indicates a good to dimensionality of over continuum. Because low energy excitation here at K point is described by the Skinner-Stevens theory, we apply the linear spin theory to evaluate the area coupling. So the white line is fit by linear spin theory using the area energy. So this energy is 5% of the exchange interaction in the triangular lattice. So the fundamental normalization of single magnum excitation in the single-half triangular lattice higher level is strongly dependent on the wave vector. So this behavior is in contrast to the fundamental normalization observed in the single-half alumina lattice under the magnum session of thin fluoride. So this compound has older Gram state due to cubical zero Gram state due to the large Janosian scheme for Lyapunov interaction. So in this compound, we observed large renormalization downwards renormalization. However, the renormalization factor is almost independent of Q. So this behavior is contrasted with the renormalization itself in one part, a triangular Heisenberg model. Now I will go to the excitation continuum subject. So the feature of the excitation spectrum is the intense dispersion, dispersive continuum, which extends about 6 meters to the ball, like given. So this is a constant energy strike with scattering intensity into the continuum energy range. At low temperatures, the position of strong scattering located near K point. However, with increasing energies, the strong scattering point shifts to K point to M point, like this. And at 8 electron volt, which is about 5 times J, so we can see weak contrast. This means the excitation continues to increase the energy. So this is the intensity as a function of energy at endpoint. So we can see three-stage energy structures. So the horizontal bar is the resolution. And blue line through these two lines is the background level. So we can see the excitation continuum has a long energy tail. The long energy tail continues at least up to 10 milliliters, which is 6 times J. So as discussed by Professor Batista and Borio, so this morning, so these strong dispersion continuum cannot describe continuously in the theory. So this means this thing strongly suggests this strong continuum, dispersion continuum, is caused by the fractionalized spin excitation. So it has been considered the fractionalized spin excitation is characteristic of spin picking around the scale. So this is the illustration of the fractionalized spin excitation. However, our experimental result indicates fractionalized spin excitation can take place even from the order of the state. So the next problem is to elucidate the nature of the fractionalization. So in this morning session, Professor Batista showed Schwinger-Boson approaches, which describes very well the strong dispersion excitation. Therefore, we are waiting for the progress of saving. So this is the summary of my talk. So we present a result of excitation by Kovalt-Mantimov, which is a good realization. The feature of Heisenberg excitation is first the three-stage energy structures. The lowest stage is composed of single magnum excitation. The single magnum excitation energy is significantly renormalized by quantum fluctuation. So we observe the proton light, which has benefited from theory. So the excitation spectrum has intense dispersive excitation which extends about 10 million, which is about 6 times J. So the single magma excitation is probably somewhat undated, somewhat outdated from this consistent with itself. However, for the excitation continuum, there is still distance between our experimental results. Therefore, we are waiting the path of progress itself. Thank you very much for your attention.
I'm just curious, the 6J would require how many magnons roughly?
Six magnons.